Yeah, good morning and thank you very much, Herr Hausmann, for the nice words. And truly, I lost my heart for the cultural heritage. I came here as a biochemist and now I'm really somebody who's much more in the whole topic of cultural heritage in an analog and a digital way. So thank you very much. And thank you also for hosting that conference here. It's a little hot, but I hope that you will survive. Yeah, welcome to all of you. I already said hello to some of you. I'm glad you all are here. And actually I'm very, very happy that the State and University Library is a member of the IIIF, or International Image Interoperability Framework. It's hosting this conference, and that so many of you came here is a good sign, and I congratulate you. As you might have noticed in the past days, it's a really small town. I learned that some of you know it already. But our university and our partners on the Göttingen campus, these are 8 non-university research centers, are located in this little town, and then it means that the whole town is a campus in a way. And so it is a very lively and particular very international campus. And that really is also profiling the face of the city. A lot is happening here in Göttingen, also in your field of research and methodology. The State and University Library has a proven expertise in topics such as data literacy, digital edition, and research infrastructure. Also, images and objects as knowledge carriers play a special role for the university. For example, the Gutenberg Bible, which is kept in the historical building of the State and University Library. I hope you had a chance to see that, the building, the old building, and is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. And that's your topic, through digitization, it has been made accessible to researchers and the public in a new and more comprehensive way. IIIF has also been used for the digital edition of notebooks of Theodor Fontane, one of the most important German writers in the 19th century. And in this year, his 200th anniversary of his birth is celebrated. As you know, not only research, but also the public is very much interested in the material evidence of intellectual history. This material evidence does not include only text, like I mentioned the Gutenberg Bible and the Fontane notebook, but, and that's close to my heart as being an experimental scientist, objects of various types. At the University of Göttingen, we have many collections. It's much more than 40, and it's a question how you count it. If you count all single collections, there are many, many more. And those objects are linked to the intellectual history, ranging from mathematical models and instruments to cast collections of antique sculptures, and one of the largest ELGEL service collection of the world. It's very interesting to see all the little elks or ELGAs there, the little water plants. We are proud of this heritage collected here in Göttingen, and we want to share it with the public. Certainly also with you, but particularly with the public. The local public, but also with the interested and especially scientific public around the world. For this, we, and when I say we, I have to say it's mainly on one side the library, and on the other side the what we call central custodian, which we introduced to take care for all the objects. So, and this is a very close connection and a very important part, and that's when I say we, what I mean. So we make great efforts about effort to digitize the collections. Our digital collection portal already contains about 30,000 objects. And you can look at it in the open access portal. It's, I'm sure that you get an easy access and see whether you like it and whether you can work with it. Presenting university collections to the public is one crucial way of sharing scientific findings. It will also happen in the Forum Wissen. That's, if you would like to translate it, it's a Forum Knowledge, or it's a modern kind of university museum, which will open in 2020 and will bring together research, teaching, and exhibitions so that there is a really knowledge transfer into the society. And what we want to show in that forum is not just show objects in an exhibition, but we want to tell stories how knowledge is developed, how knowledge comes from the object into science, or how we work with it, and in particular how people worked with it in the past. So it's important that we are able to explain what we do and how we work also to those who have never worked in academia themselves. And I think that collections and images help with that very much. Our main goal means is science communication and knowledge transfer with those object in an analog, in the forum, and digital level. Digitization opens, that's what I think, many new and intriguing possibilities for science communication as well as science collaboration, so that we can work around the globe without traveling all the time. That will be good for the climate development. Various research projects at the University of Göttingen work with resources from digital collections. And various object-oriented disciplines like art, ethnography, archaeology, digital collections play an important role in teaching. It's very good for the students to learn that way and actually get good introductions into the world of digitization. In 2017, we established a very new share, a share of materiality of knowledge that has never been here in this kind of denomination, and Frau Professor Föhringer is holding this share. As I said, good science communication in this sense requires reliable and appropriate standards, as well as access to the image-based resources. And I think what I learned is that the IIIF is all about that. I'm very happy that you are here today and that the images and digital collections which I just introduced to you, this portal, it's actually the basis for that is provided using the IIIF image and presentation. API, is that right? Good. So when I realized that, I thought I have to come and welcome you because it's very important for us, and I'm intrigued and impressed by your work. So I hope that in that sense and even much more, which I probably don't have an insight in, you will have lively discussions and you will get inspired and do that. Even so, it's pretty hot in here, but the next days might be a little cooler. Thank you very much for coming. Enjoy your stay, enjoy the discussions, and I hope that you go home with some new ideas and with a good feeling. Thank you very much.